place. It's your voice. Use it. Boom. Okay. All right. I got to get y'all because y'all missed every shout I just dropped on ya. I guess I'll give it to y'all like this. There's a bad rap artist who's out of California by the name of Sweetie, and she dropped this bar that I had to get to y'all. I wish I had memorized it, but I didn't quite memorize it. So let me read it right quick, and I'm going to shout and move into the body of this message. Look what Sweetie said. Sweetie just killed me because Sweetie is talking about what? Can't stop, ain't stop. Too hot, come out like the daughter of Aaliyah and Tupac. And I pop from the jump, ain't nobody too shocked. I guess she's got her voice because she's saying, I'm going to use my voice because God has given me this voice. And since God has given me this voice, I'm not going let any racist or sexist or someone with issues of toxic masculinity become an issue for me. I can't stop. I ain't stop. I popped out like the daughter of Aaliyah and Tupac. Y'all admit, I thought y'all were my crowd right here. Aaliyah and Tupac. I mean, that's a dangerous combination right there. Not Aaliyah and R. Kelly, but Aaliyah and Tupac. What a combination right I thought y'all were my people. Y'all are hurting my feelings right now. So let me just show you how God gets your voice back to you. God gets your voice back to you and helps you to trust your voice. Watch this. Watch my God. God is so amazing is that God uses crises and problems around us to set us up, to show us the calling that is on us and the answers that can only come from us. I said that too fast, didn't I? I'll slow it down and shout you. God is so amazing that God has given you a voice, and God will use hell breaking out around you. God will use crises and problems around you. Watch this, in order to set you up to use the voice that God has distinctly given you. God ain't given that voice to no one else. And so God knows, but if a crisis pops up or a problem shows up, a lot of us, here it is, have been pushed into purpose by a problem. Boom, you better get that one more time. You see, it's not that we just woke up one day and said, God, what's my purpose? And God said, here it is. But for some of us, it was like God said, I got to have a little problem right here. And the problem began to push us and push us. And the next thing we know, we discovered why God had made us to begin with, because God can use problems and pain to push us to our purpose. And somebody came to church today. You've been trying to figure out what the hell is all this mess I'm dealing with about. God says, I allow the hell you go through so you can hear from heaven about the purpose I'm using you for. And somebody's here. That's your shout right there. Go ahead, get your shout on, because you've been to hell and back, but God gave you a round trip ticket. And when God gave you that round trip ticket, God put on that ticket stamp purpose. Your purpose is to use what you've been through so I can accomplish through you what you wouldn't have had accomplished had you not been through it. Because you've been through it, you're stronger. Because you've been through it, you're more sensitive. Because you've been through it, you got more compassion. Because you've been through it, you got more heart. Because you've been through it, you got more wisdom. Anybody glad you've been through it? Okay. All right, let me help the rest of y'all, because some of y'all are not getting it. I'm going to help y'all right quick. So this morning, I do what I normally do, brushing teeth, and getting ready to put the toothpaste, watch this, on the toothbrush. And the toothpaste said, yo, Freddie. I'm not losing my mind. I'm really all right, okay? Don't think I'm hallucinating. I'm really okay. I said, hold on. I said, first of all, I got you ready to church, preach. I can't go crazy with toothpaste talking to me. And toothpaste said, I got to talk to you. Because in your second point, folk are going to want to know. Or folk are going to want to know in your first point how problems and crises can push them to purpose. I said, well, how you talking anyway? Toothpaste said, Shakespeare said there are sermons in stones. Jesus said, if these hold their peace, the rocks will cry out. So if sermons can come from stones and rocks can rejoice, you can get theology from toothpaste. Preach, Freddie Haynes, I am. And so watch this. The toothpaste said, now you wanna use me to do what I was made to do. Is that right? I said, of course I do. He said, well, how you gonna get out of me what's in me? Okay, how are you gonna get out of me what the manufacturer put in me? How are you gonna get out of me what the one who made me put in me in order for me to render the service I've been called to do? I said, oh, that's easy. I got to squeeze you. And every now and then God says, I got something in you, but I can't get it out of you until I squeeze you. Anybody ever been squeezed? When you get squeezed, God ain't trying to crush you. God is trying to bring out of you what God has placed in you. Preach, Freddie. I am. Okay, I got to get y'all. So look at the text. The text blows me away, because the crisis is what? The crisis is that the temple is undergoing repairs. And while the temple was undergoing repairs, here comes your shout. They discovered in the brokenness the Torah. They discovered passages from Deuteronomy. They discovered it, watch this, while the temple was broken. Okay, the Torah had gotten lost in church. Okay, the word had gotten lost in church, because if you're not careful, the word can get lost in church. How did the word get found? The word got found when stuff got broken, because every now and then God will let stuff break down in your life in order for you to discover what God is trying to get to you by way of a word that's for your life. Okay, I gotta come back over here, because they're not trying to feel me. Here's your shout right here. The shout is this. The shout is that while they were digging, they found the word. They bring the word to the king, Josiah. Josiah gets the word, and Josiah breaks down weeping and repenting. And when he breaks down weeping and repenting, he says, we need a preacher to interpret this. Now, here's what messed me up. Y'all do know this is during the reign of Josiah. And some scholars say that Jeremiah is prophesying during this time. But he don't send them to Jeremiah. He says a sister needs to deal with this. And the text says they don't go to Jeremiah or any other prophet in the prophetic guild. They go to a woman by the name of Huldah. And when they get to Huldah, Huldah is letting us know, if it had not been for the crisis and the brokenness, they would not have gotten to her. But because of the crisis and the brokenness, that's how they came to her. And that's all I'm trying to say to somebody. God will let stuff break down around you in order to